Hello, Bridger Fellow family. Welcome to Children's Church Holiday Edition. For the next few weeks, we are going to be preparing for the birth of King Jesus. Through these stories, our hearts will discover the beautiful anticipations of how the light of the world came to change our story. Be with us for the rest of the year as we celebrate. Before we get into our program, Alex has some guidelines.
Guys, here's some tips to help you with service today. Tip number one, listen and pay attention until the end. Tip number two, sing and participate in each activity. Tip number three, try to remember the key verse from today. See you later.
Super big, super strong, super wonderful. scripture?
Sure.
You can find this in John 3:17.
Got it.
Do you want me to read? God did not send his son into the world to judge the world guilty, but to save the world through him.
Do you want me to read the story for today?
Sure.
The priest Zechariah doubted an angel's message to him that his aging wife Elizabeth would have a son who would prepare the way for the Lord. Because of his unbelief, Zechariah was struck with an inability to speak until the baby was born. When John was born, Zechariah was suddenly able to speak again. Filled with the Holy Spirit, Zechariah said what would happen before it happened. That is called a prophecy. He told his friends and neighbors that his son would be called John and that he would prepare the way for Jesus, our King. In today's lesson, let's ask God to help us see the ways he wants us to live and how much we need him. The Bible teaches us that without Jesus, we fall short and we could not have a relationship with God. As humans, we don't measure up to God. Jesus is the bridge. He is a way for us to have a relationship with God. When we acknowledge that we need Jesus, we can take action and obey him. For all children listening, if you're wondering what sin is anything that separates us from God and that goes against his desire for us.
Hey guys, welcome back to Get Fit with God.
We exercise to make your hearts and bodies stronger and always healthier.
Just like we can exercise to make our hearts and bodies stronger, we can also exercise to make our hearts and bodies stronger by reading the Bible, studying the Bible, and more.
Today's exercise is
side planks and push-ups.
This also works your core, but mainly your core. I'll demonstrate, and here we do the modification. All right, so first you're gonna start off with getting into a plank, and then you're gonna go to your side, and then you're going to go back into the middle and do a push-up, then go back onto the other side, and then do a push-up, and we're just gonna keep doing that. Awesome. If your legs get tired or your arms, you can also sit down like I'm doing right now and just take a little break. Now, here we do the modification.
The modification is if when you do your side plank, you can just put one knee down if you get too tired, and if you do your push-up, put your knees down. And yeah.
Let's start off with doing five.
If you get tired, you can just pause for a second and then come right back in.
Let's start.
One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Now that was a great workout today. I'm sorry to say, but that's it for today.
We'll see you next time on Get Fit with God.
Hello, Bridge of Hope. I'm Brielle Lamb, and welcome to another episode of Bridge Kids Storytime. Today's story is Zechariah Prophesizes About Jesus. Today's story can be found in Luke chapter 1, verses 68 through 79. And now for our cast. Elizabeth. Zechariah. And now for our story. An angel appeared to Zechariah and gave him a message from God that Zechariah and his wife Elizabeth would have a son that would prepare the way for the coming of the Lord. Zechariah doubted the angel because he and Elizabeth were old in age. But because of his unbelief, Zechariah was unable to speak until the baby was born. When the baby was born, Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and delivered the prophecy that his son would be named John, and later known as John the Baptist. He would be a prophet and remind the people of salvation. John would prepare the way for Jesus to come and bring light into the world and forgiveness for our sins.
And that was Bridge Kids Story Time!
Hi, my name is Jada. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for Jesus. Thank you for making a way for us to know you and follow you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Merry Christmas, Bridgewell!
Today we're celebrating the season of Advent, and we're making Christmas angels to represent it. Here's our ingredients.
So we're going to use a bugle for the body, and you're just going to put like a dab of frosting on there. And we used the Captain Crunch peanut butter cereal to make the head. And then you're just gonna use like a Cheerio, or we used a Honey Nut Cheerio so it tastes better. And you're gonna put that on there for the halo. And then you're just gonna place some on these pretzels for the wings. And ta-da, you have a Christmas angel.
Good.
Welcome to Bridge of Hope Craft Corner. I'm Miss Erin.
I'm Ben.
And today we're going to be talking about the greatest gift. So the things that you'll need for your craft today are
some scissors,
pens.
Yes, pens. A small box.
You'll need a gift tag for the outside, and then you'll need another piece of paper for the inside.
Some wrapping paper and some tape.
Okay, so today we are talking about the greatest gift. And I'm going to read a small scripture. And then we're going to talk about what the greatest gift is. Luke chapter 2, verse 10. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy for all people." Now that's only part of the verse. What was that good news? Do you know what the good news was that the angel brought? No, it was that a Savior, Jesus, was born. Jesus is God's Son, and He came to the world so that we can be saved and loved by Him. Today, we're going to wrap a small box, and inside that box, I have a little tag here that says, "Jesus is the reason for the season." Ben will help me wrap it, and once we've wrapped it, we'll put this tag on it. This tag says, "The greatest gift." On the back, it says, "From God to the world." The greatest gift, which is Jesus, is for everyone. You just have to accept that Jesus is God's Son, believe that He came to save you from all the bad things and sins that you have done, and so that you can live with Him forever in heaven. And then you have to confess, which means to tell Jesus that you are sorry for all the bad things that you've done, and that you don't want to do all those bad things, that you want to follow him and you want to live with him forever in heaven. And that's all you have to do to receive the greatest gift. So we'll be back. Ben's going to do some wrapping and then we'll come back. We hope that this Christmas you remember what the greatest gift is, and that's
Jesus.
We hope to see you next week, and Merry Christmas!
Bye!
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Children's Church. Thank you for joining us today in this wonderful lesson in preparation for Christmas. So just like the first Christmas, there was someone who was born before. His name was John the Baptist. So John the Baptist was a miracle baby because his mom and his dad could not have babies, and God gave them John the Baptist in their old age. So today was a wonderful reminder that just like John the Baptist prepared the way for Jesus, Jesus is preparing our hearts for meeting him. Not only celebrating him, but meeting him as well. So how are you preparing your heart for Jesus? And it's a great reminder also that we all need Jesus, that Jesus came for all of us, and that without him, we really have no way to the Father. We have no way to be friends with God. So we all fall short, and Jesus is like that bridge that makes a way for us to the Father. So thank you for joining us today. We hope that you will continue to think through the truth of this story, and that you will continue to celebrate with us the birth of Jesus. God bless you.
Stop it, when you have started.